I had the distinct pleasure of celebrating the 40th anniversary of WOAR at an event in Philadelphia a few months back, and it was at this celebration that I shared these sentiments. Although each of us gathered here today are thrilled to know that WOAR has been in existence for 40 years, we would be equally thrilled to never have to celebrate another year of organizing Women Against Rape in Pennsylvania. We would completely forfeit our right to celebrate 50 years of this esteemed organization if it meant that women across this Commonwealth were finally safe in their homes and in their communities. If it meant that a third of the women in this country were no longer guaranteed to be raped at some point in their life, and if it meant that a quarter of those assaults would not occur before the victim's 18th birthday. With House Resolution 147, the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania formally and officially recognizes the Women Organized Against Rape organization, not only as the founders of America's first rape crisis center some 40 years ago, but also as an outstanding example of what can be accomplished when people mobilize for a cause. The unfortunate truth is, every bit of the assistance WOAR provides is needed today, just as it was when the organization was established at the Philadelphia General Hospital back in 1973. For more than four decades, WOAR has been a leading nonprofit organization whose mission has been to eliminate all forms of sexual violence. WOAR has advocated for the rights of victims of sexual assault and abuse through direct services, education, and training programs for both children and adults. In addition, WOAR has developed a direct service department that provides a 24-hour hotline, free individual and group counseling to children and adults, counseling in Spanish, hospital and court accompaniment, and Latino outreach services. Finally, their most recent accomplishment is the creation and implementation of the Philadelphia Sexual Assault Response Center, which is a first-of-its-kind rape trauma center. Although we are celebrating its 40th birthday, it is important to note that WOAR actually operated underground a few years prior to its official capacity, because back then, unless a woman was bruised, beaten, or worse, she was often blamed for her own rape, victimizing the victim yet again. Thank God we've come a long way, baby. Now, without further ado, will you please join me in a round of applause to honor and celebrate WOAR's efforts to end sexual violence and abuse and its 40 years spent in the trenches combating violence against women. Thank you, WOAR, for all you do. And thank you, Mr. Speaker.